You may have been wondering whether the BB84 protocol is not overly complicated. And maybe we can make it a bit more efficient by removing certain steps and requirements. To think about this, and this is the perspective that is useful to analyze all cryptographic protocols, we will actually think like an adversary. For the rest of this video, imagine that you are the eavesdropper Eve. Your goal will be to learn the keys of Alice and Bob. Let me just put out the protocol again. And there was a step after we distributed BB84 states where Bob announces receipt of these states. You might say, maybe this slows things down. Why do I need this step? In order to think about this, let's remove it and let's think like an adversary to find an attack. I encourage you to pause this video for a moment and find an attack after I removed step 2. Let's now imagine that we're Eve. Alice and Bob distributed BB84 states. And now Alice is going to send Bob her basis string, theta. If Alice sends her basis string, theta, to Bob, over the classical channel, Eve can of course also read the basis string. Remember that if they communicate over the classical channel, Eve can read all the messages. Bob knows that the message came from Alice, but Eve can read it. This means that Eve could store in her perfect and all-powerful system, namely a huge quantum memory, she could store all the qubits that Alice has sent to Bob in this step. Now she's going to wait until Alice announces her basis string theta. She's going to measure all the qubits in exactly the correct basis, introducing very little noise, if any, and simply prepare the state again and send it to Bob. Now Eve has learned the entire string X. All of it. Clearly, if Eve knows the entire string, even after all the other processing that we've done, we know that there's not enough min entropy for Eve. The min entropy, in fact, is zero. And hence, we cannot produce any key. You might also be wondering, why do we need this funny authenticator channel? Maybe we can get rid of it. So let's imagine that we would not have an authenticator channel. Again, pause the video for a second and think about an attack against the protocol. If there's no authenticator channel, and we are Eve, we can now perform what is called a man-in-the-middle attack. Eve is going to sit directly between Alice and Bob, and she's going to listen to all the communication on the quantum channel. Whenever she receives a qubit from Alice, she's just going to pretend to be Bob. She's going to measure it and do everything as Bob would do in the protocol. Towards Bob, she will pretend to be Alice. So Alice runs a protocol with Eve, basically generating a key shared between Alice and Eve. Eve runs a protocol with Bob, generating a key, Eve, Bob. So at the end, there's a situation where Eve shares a key with Alice and Bob shares a key with Eve. This is clearly not a desirable situation for communication, because if Alice now uses the key to communicate using the one-time pad, Eve can read all of her communication. She can encrypt it again with the key that she shares with Bob and send it to him. And Alice and Bob will never notice that anything happened. So for sure, we want to have an authenticated channel.